TonyVarsitySportsNetwork.com here at Gilman School. Dusk has begun to settle over here in Roland Park, but it's a happy night for the McDonogh Eagles as they won the 99th meeting between these two great rivals, 21-14 in overtime. A lot of things didn't go right for the Eagles most of the afternoon, but Kareem Montgomery and his teammates, man, just found that inner strength that has helped them win back-to-back MIAA conference title. And Kareem, just talk about the fortitude of this team, man. A lot of things weren't going right, man. I still don't know how you guys actually won this game.
We had the battle. That was the message, because we knew they were going to come out strong after last year. And we knew it was going to be a tough battle. They're a really good team, well-coached also. We were prepared, but as Dom said, we had to make some plays. Mm-hmm. And that was going to be defense, offense, special teams, so we couple balls bounced away, got a couple of fumble recoveries. Mm-hmm. Was able to turn around, mm-hmm. punch it in, and great stop. Big hit by Eric Burrell. Mm-hmm. OT, caused a fumble, and I was happy enough to be there. I just fell on it, and after that, it's history right there.
Yeah, it was a perfect time, because you also had a fumble recovery, I think, on the sidelines. I think it was Jelani's fumble recovery. Just kind of talk about that. Just talk about just making plays. Sometimes you just need to make a play, something to change the thing.
See, before the half, we killed this. Jelani caught it, great play. Mm-hmm. We missed a tackle. He goes 60 yards. So after that, we was like, well, they're not like out scheming us. We just have to make plays. And we had the gang tackle. Mm-hmm. You know, Wyatt came to us and held gang tackle, hold him up, strip the ball. Mm-hmm. And, you know, after that, we had 4 or 5 fumble recoveries because of that. Everyone swarming to the ball. Mm-hmm. It wasn't just it was Najee and Cam on the sideline making a tackle against Jelani. So after that, the third person coming in, got to get the ball. So swarming to the ball was key in the second half.
Right, and just talk about the offense. Got off to a quick start, but it was kind of stagnant. But fourth quarter, got some things from Malik. And then I thought something that kind of got forgotten, your third down catch across the middle.
Well, we knew we had to get behind our seniors and our offensive line, Ellis, you know, Wyatt. Got some good guys, Jordan's young guy, Chase and Bart. They really stepped up today. We was like, guys, we're on the side of the 50, so now we got to punch it in. You know, we got behind our horses, and we do. Our formation come downhill. Malik, great vision. Malik and Nigel Scott, man, they ran well all year, you know. And Jansen, that third down play, he put it in the spot. I was like, all right, I got to go up and make a play. I got to do something for our offense so we can keep going.
Back-to-back MIAA conference champions, man. Just talk about these last couple of years for McDonogh football.
I think Wyatt said it the best at the end of the year. You know, Gilman, they have been the model for teams around here. And you strive to be – you want to be on the top. And you strive to be as good as they are. And I think that, especially with the senior class at McDonogh, we got the message. We worked our butts off. Coaches amped it up for us, and they gave us a big responsibility, and I think we answered the call really well.
All right. Well, Kareem Montgomery had a big day. Had a big third down catch late in regulation. Came with a couple of fumble recoveries, including the one that seals victory in overtime for McDonogh School, 21-14, as, again, they are MIAA, a conference football champions. For VarsitySportsNetwork.com, I'm Derek Toney.